and MBA HR student from BS NMITD, and have also worked with Airfuse Aviation Private Limited as an HR manager intern. So today, we will be knowing how we can use NLP techniques in NLP to unleash our fullest potential. So are we ready to begin? And y'all can hear me properly, right? So we'll start with the share screen option. Yes, thank you. Thank you for responses, Akanksha, Krutika, Kavya. And really sorry for the inconvenience. There was internet issue at my end. So we had to wait for some time. Yeah, so y'all can see my screen, right? Okay. Before we begin, I would request all of y'all to keep your videos off and keep yourself muted. Also, I will be keeping my video on and off in between for smooth flow of the webinar. So before I start to tell y'all what is NLP, I would like to know what do you understand by NLP? Do you know the full form? You can type in the chat and let me know. And please be very active in the chat box, because that will keep me motivated and help me to go ahead. You can type in the chat what is your understanding of NLP. And then I'll give you what it means according to me. Yes. Okay. Yes. So, what is NLP? A set of practical tools that act as a metaphor to the unconscious mind. We can call NLP as a tool because I'll break down the term for you. Neuro, N for neuro. Neuro means related to the brain. L, linguistic, is a language of the brain. And P means programming, that is the way you think or act. So with the help of NLP, we can program our mind in such a way that we can achieve the desired results in our life and, you know, and achieve success. So if there's any audibility problem, then please let me know by unmuting yourself. Okay. So it lays down the foundation of personal power. Now, once you come to know how you can use NLP in your real life to achieve success, you get personal power, right? You can control your mind, your brain. And for this, in NLP, in the context of NLP, sensory acuity means the use of our senses, that is our eyes, the visual, auditory, gustatory, kinesthetic, using these senses in order to think and understand the working of the brain. Now I'll give you a small example of this. Okay, if you'll smell fire right now when you're attending the webinar, what will you do? Will you sit down here or you'll run away? Yes, you will run away, because the moment we smell fire or we are at a height, our brain is programmed in such a manner that we know it is dangerous for us and we should not wait for a long time over there. Yes. So this is what NLP is, and we have been using it from the childhood, but unconsciously. And now we will start using it consciously. So I want you to type in the chat box and let me know if you all are excited to begin with the techniques. Yes. You know, we can use NLP. By using NLP, we can achieve the desired results. And especially for people, you know, who find it difficult to meet timelines or deadlines. By use of NLP, you can meet the timelines, and you know, not only deliver it on time, but also over deliver to your clients. So the first technique is a presupposition. The map is not the territory. Now, the map is our point of view, the way we look at things or situations, not the territory. Territory means the actual situation. Okay. Now, for instance, I might have some point of view towards a situation which will differ from person to person. Okay. But I will feel that the map, that is my point of view to the way I look at things, is the actual way it has happened. To give you an example, now if you are walking on the road and you see one of your friends or your colleagues passing by, what will we do? We will call them, yeah? But that friend ignores you, and the moment you call his name, he runs away from there. Then you might be thinking for many days ahead that, why did my friend avoid me? Why did my friend avoid me? Why didn't he respond? And after more few days, you might, generalize the reality as, people in my surroundings dislike me. So this is generalization, yes. But to tell you, the reality is, when the friend who was passing by was wearing earphones in his ears, and the moment you called his name, he saw his bus coming, and that is why to catch the bus he ran. Okay, so now you understood how much that person's point of view differed from the reality. Yes, so your view of the world, the map, is just a fragment of the total. That is, fragment in the sense, very small part of the total absolute reality, the territory. And by using this technique, we can actually be good decision makers also. The second presupposition is, people work perfectly. People work perfectly. So that is, behind every behavior lies a positive intention. I'll explain this again with the help of an example. Now, very famous motivational speaker, Robin Sharma, he says that there are 98% of people in the world whose intention is to help others, and only 2% of the people who intend to destroy or, cause destruction in other people's life. So from this, what can we derive? We can understand that maximum number of people around us want to help us. Yes. But then why do they disappoint us sometimes? Why do we become angry, or why do others irritate us? If they really want to help, then why do people disappoint us? So the answer to this is that the people who have positive intention but lack at the competency level fail to help you. So it is, intention versus competencies. So we need to build the competencies. We need to build the competencies required so that we can help others. And as a leader, it is very important for us to trust others, to trust your teammates. Okay. The reason is, if in your team you feel that people, do not work properly, they are not giving their 100%, or you distrust your team members, then you will not be able to go work properly. Because if you distrust people, you will not be able to work properly. So for that, we need to assume, presupposition is a kind of an assumption, okay, that people work perfectly. At least, at the intention level, they want to help. Yeah, and I'll take a small water break. The third one is also a presupposition. It reads, you cannot not communicate. Okay, this means that you cannot not communicate. It means that we human beings communicate at multiple levels and in multiple ways. And it is also said that words constitute to only 7% of our communication. So that means the rest is judged on your body language and your pitch and tonality. Yes? I'll give you again an example. For instance, in this webinar, now, there are a few people, when I ask questions, they are responding. Okay. But others, there are some people who are not responding. So then their silence right now is also a communication that maybe they understand that this question is not asked to them, or they are not in the mood to talk, or they might be angry, or it could be the Basundi effect. Now you will wonder, what is Basundi effect? I'll tell you. Basundi effect is if you have had a heavy lunch and then had a sweet dish after lunch, then you will definitely feel sleepy. So I can understand you all can be sleepy also. Okay. Yes, so this is the Basundi effect. Then how many of y'all, before proceeding ahead, again I want y'all to be active in the chat box and type and tell me how to build rapport according to you. How can we build rapport? And how important it is to build rapport? Yes. Yes. So, please mute yourself. Yeah. So, building rapport. Building rapport is said to be an art, hence the most important of all. Now, do you know why do we consider building rapport the most important? Because it is an art. Everyone cannot build rapport. Okay. And building rapport is said to be, is said that you are speaking the other person's language. You are looking at the world from the point of view of your friend, your client, or a colleague with whom you are trying to build rapport. Now, how to build rapport, you must be wondering. To build rapport, you need to find common grounds. That is some similarity in the life, or some problem comes in our life. Don't keep on saying it as problem, because the subconscious mind is listening to your self-talk. Instead, you can address the word problem or shift the word problem by calling it as a challenge. Yeah, so that can bring really a lot of positivity in us. And you should see every situation in your life as an opportunity for growth. Now, are you curious to go ahead? If yes, then please type in the chat box curious and let me know. Please be very active in the chat box. So it gives me positive energy. Yeah. Thank you for your responses. Yes, I hope that y'all are not in the Basundi effect. Yeah, y'all are here and present over here. Yes. Now, as we come to the conclusion of the topic, I would like to tell y'all that if you feel that by knowing these NLP techniques, your life is going to, change suddenly, or there's going to be some magic in your life, then please don't think that way, because knowing NLP techniques is not just enough. You need to apply them in your life. That is also very important, and be consistent in it. So if you apply them consistently, then yes, you can use these techniques as a vehicle or tool and achieve the results which you want in your life. So see, there are two treasure boxes. At the left side, there is a closed treasure box. And the right side, there's an open treasure box. And there's a key above. So NLP techniques is just like the key. Okay, now I have given you the keys. You have to open that treasure box, that is your brain, and then get all the gold and treasure. Yeah, with having trust and consistency in the techniques. So go and unleash your fullest potential, and I'm sure you all must have enjoyed this webinar. And thank you for being there with me throughout the webinar. Thank you. Thanks a lot. And now we are open to question and answers. Questions, if you all have any questions. You all can type in the chat box. It's just that I'm not able to see my chats. Yeah, any questions? Can someone unmute and tell me because I cannot read the chats. Yeah, Akanksha. Okay. Can you give an example of reframing? Okay, Akanksha. An example of reframing can be, I'll give you my own example. Yes, and even Kritika has a question. Okay, I'll just take 15 seconds water break because my throat is really drying up. Thank you. So can you give an example of reframing? So to give you an example, my own example, during my teenage, I had a lot of body shaming issues. Okay. For I used to body shame myself because I was very fat. Then I had so many pimples, then hair fall, all those things, hormonal issues. So then, I used to say a lot of negative things like, why am I like this, or I'm not beautiful, or this, that, all that negative self-talk. And slowly and steadily, as I grew as an adult, when I was 19, 20, I realized that this is a negative self-talk and it is not helping. Some of my friends, they really helped me and told me that, you should use reframing or affirmations in your life. So I started seeing when I get up early in the morning, I used to look at my face and say that, I love you. You are the best. I stopped seeing the negative things, that how many pimples are there on my face, or how am I looking? Am I fat or thin? I just saw the positive things. Okay, I have two eyes, I have nose, lips, everything is proper, and I look the best. Okay, you are the best. I started seeing this, and within a few months, I could experience the result of it. Yeah, and that is how I am able to be positive in this situation during these times also, and deliver this webinar. So that was an example of reframing, how I reframed my negative self-talk to positive ones. Yeah. Yes. So Sonali has an example. Question. What is the use of NLP in corporate scenario after this pandemic and how it works? So after the pandemic, what I feel genuinely is that we need to look at all the situations optimistically, and there are going to be many challenges for HRs especially, but as you address different situations, try to be empathetic as much as you can. And even I'm little, when I read little bit of whatever research or articles, I come to know that motivational speakers and everyone, they are saying that there are few leaders who are not empathetic. So after the COVID and also during COVID times, during interviews, they want to get managers who are empathetic. So they are seeing that skill. So try to be more empathetic and connect with your people. So that will somehow help you, is what I feel. And there was one more question, I guess. Will these techniques really work? So they will work. As I said, you need to trust them and be consistent in practicing the techniques, and you will definitely see the results. Okay, then I think we can conclude the webinar. Yeah, thank you.